this passes. But I'm going to ask Mr. Davis, the House of the WB, to come up and give everybody our first glimpse as of tomorrow. This will be available live and emergency changes. So please, we ask everybody to please use the comment sections that are available on every page of the website. Help us to make it better and more active and more valuable to you as users. And you'll see lots of changes happening in the coming months. Our first strike is now.
Thank you, Dan. The Utah website that we present tonight is probably the most usual book about residents and businesses in town with DLC and appreciate. Aside from the modern design and updating the Google Field website, there's a lot of features, technology, information, and the website that we all go through. This is the initial page of the website that you come to. We will be getting images from iconic areas of town, Lakewood, and as well as other information on the website. We're just going to briefly go through the website in different sections, and I'm going to go through the details so you can get an idea of what it is, and everyone can obviously spend their time on their own going through it, as well as one of the things. Zooming in a little bit, as a welcome to the Lakewood Township. Below that is on the homepage, the upcoming township events, township updates, so constantly township has the ability to put information on there. One of the important things that we did with this website is that we gave the township the ability to do a lot of this on its own. Each department has the ability to make the changes to the website so that the information won't get stale, will stay fresh, and that people will be a lot of information on there that people can take advantage of. The top of the website, we have the alert, which is important many times. There's something that's not typical needs to get out on the website. We'll post it there right now. We'll post it on Monday or July 4th weekend. No township will also be closed. One of the main keys on the website was to make it easy on navigation, to make it easy for people to get through the website and take advantage of it. We tried to spend a lot of time doing that. As a matter of fact, the name, the web address itself is much easier now. It's lakewoodnj.gov. So the new website is lakewoodnj.gov that you can go to. Not always on the top of the website, we have the typical links for navigation. We split up into six departments. Everyone knows which direction you're going to. On the right-hand side, we did a quick links for things that are most commonly asked for. If you come to the website, you can see it for birth certificates or obtaining traffic tickets or anything to get to it. And for those who can't find it easily, we have a search at the top of the page, putting in that looking trash pickup, good results, and first one being, in this case, a quickly asked question section, look for answers for it, follow a department for those who don't follow the rules for the trash pickup. Also, the bottom of every single page throughout, for the same reason, is a
if you could speak a little bit more into the mic. Is everyone able to hear me
say it?
Okay, so a little louder and a little more into the mic.
Slower.
For those who weren't following, one of the main keys that I'm going to go over again was the ease of navigation so people could get through the website, and we made numerous different attempts to make this website easy for people to use. So some of the areas that were mentioned also now on the bottom of every single page, there's a sub-navigation, a little site map of all the departments and all sections of the website, so any kind of looking for you can find it. On the top is a search of all the main departments, and a lot of pages have quick links, which try to find what's more commonly asked for the section. I'm going to go quickly, just through a few of the pages, just to get an idea, and then we'll go from there. The department section is the first section. If you come to the department section, it provides different categories. Each category has a little bit of description about which what to expect from there, so you know what to go to, as well as in the beginning, as well as the bullets at the bottom, letting you see which departments are in there. So if you're looking, for instance, for the UAC, and you're not sure where you would fall in, you can see on the bullets in the bottom exactly where it goes. I'm going to click on the economic development, which includes the UAC as I mentioned. And this will take you to the economic development page with the specific departments that are in there. Again, I'm not going to focus on the detail, but that description has also alerts. If anyone has any comments, alert, you see it right there. I'm going to go through to a specific department. I'm going to choose one just to show. Each department has a web section which has all the information about the department. As you see here, it has, well, obviously the department head with their title, it has a link to see the board members, in this case, open to sign up for email updates from them. But it also has a lot of information that anybody who needs to find anything about any of the departments can do it. We saw the page before it said that there's an alert. That's what we hear, they mentioned about their expo. So they put an alert on the top of the page, the description underneath it. Some of the areas I will just go through quickly. Updates, each department, as I mentioned earlier, can put up the updates on their own, allowing them to get the message out and allowing people to be in the loop whenever they need to know. useful links for resources, sending people who, for the typical question that people ask, where they can go to, a download center, which allows people to download any applications and forms that they would use in this department, so they don't have to download it, it's actually going to get it. Below it, there's a frequently asked questions section, click on any question, click on the answer right below it, and to the right of that is a contact page allowing people to contact the specific departments directly. With the contact information, as well as filling out a form to send an email to them directly. Moving on, and obviously every department has the same thing, there's other areas here also, but we move on to the business section. This is the general information about the Lakewood Township. For people on the general information, there's a visitor guide you can download, the PDF, to get detailed information about a lot of it. There's also the areas of the bottom, which are divided up into different areas that you can look at, you can take education, parks and recreation, health and travel. Each section goes into more details and keep going as you go down to more detail. Once again, with the equipment, the typical things that people ask for, they're looking for these areas. So the things that they would want to ask for are right here, whether it's the legal airport, business, etc., right there on the side for you to find. We're going to pick one for a second and say go through very briefly without going into details. Parks and recreation, you click on it, it has the different types of areas that fall under the golf courses, the parks, the playground, recreational program, first energy park. You click on any one of them, they give you the details about it. There's a lot of details about each one, which you can find any information that you need to. We'll move on quickly to the next section, news and events, what you would expect it to be. There's a updates on the side for township updates, the any information you use on the township, the calendar, next with all the committee meetings, etc. support on the township, people get all the information they need. Press releases, township legal notices, local events like the July 4th, extravaganza that we have again. Resources is probably the one that you can take the most advantage of, or for most people, as a lot of the most information there for all different areas of it. Briefly just to describe again the quick links to areas that people expect the most. Social resources, we have 8 different sections that will tell you all about different organizations for each area that people might tell from. Whether it's health, financial, or community, and each organization has information on it, as well as the.
But I have a quick question for you. So last time I was a resident of Indiana, I had a quick question. My client code, how I got released.
Well, you got my name.
Oh, it's fine. There's a client up on the website.
So there's a search at the top of the page, first of all, it always helps the easiest thing. If you're looking to get to a department, on top of it, at different departments, you can.
And Mr. Mayor, that was one of the FAQs brought up by the police department, and they had.
So you get to the police department, all that people have questions, frequently asked questions, and please go further from there.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
Okay, going quickly, download center FAQ, which we want to do quickly. If you want to get there, here is also for the full FAQ, the whole download, which if you're not sure where you can find it, you go to the FAQ general page, and everything will be able to find all unlisted there. Contact us about you find information about the general contact information on the bottom of each department is available. There's also a form you can fill out if you choose which department you want to go to. So if you have a specific question for a police department, you can go right there and set it out. That's basically the gist of it. I mean, there's a couple of different features throughout the website. I'll just put one on quickly to show you that. You go to the tax assessment office. You can do a lookup for different properties by block, or property address. We'll take it right now. 2/3 is here, will be the results of the value of the properties, which is and which is available to the public and other areas that we don't do that and make it available to you. That's basically just it.
Thank you very much. I much appreciate it. I really appreciate this. We've been together a lot of times. I know that the mayor, we're working on this as well together with the environment. Both of you, kudos for working on this and making it happen. This will make things for our residents and our constituents much easier to search without necessitating phone calls to town hall, to be able to find this information readily and easily on the website.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Mayor, if someone does go to the old web address, it will point them to the new web address.
Yes,
and I have to push
over.
There will be bumps and there will be issues. And I encourage people to do they let us know, so we can fix it. And, you know, we can fix it. And I think that this website brings a lot of transparency to our government. I think it makes the country more open place. And overall, I think it's great. So I want to thank you all for working on it, your hard work, and for all the department heads that gave you the information that that's on the map. So thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Okay.
At this point in time, we're going to open the mic to the public.